This one I call forgot what I call this one. Hang on a second. Cut. Okay. Craig Cameron here, and we're talking about knots. Last time we talked about a bowline knot, and we're using the bowline knot because it doesn't slip and won't get you into trouble where you can't undo that knot. But this time I'm going to show you what I call a better bowline. This one here really is handy. I call it a stockman's bowline. Remember last time when we did the true bowline? Remember I said make the hole, drop it through the hole, come back through, and pull it down. Now, that's a dang good bowline, but every time you undo it, look, you got to pull the tail back through the hole. So that's why I call this one a better bowline, my stockman's bowline. Watch this. Make that hole. Pretty simple. Now, instead of going through the hole, go around the hole, just like that. Now, it's going to be the same. I'm going to back it back through there, just like this. And remember, every knot, you got to pull them down. Watch, that's not going to slip. What makes this a better bowline? When I undo my knot, look, I don't have to pull it out from that hole right there. Let's look at that one more time. This knot I'm showing you right here, right now, is probably the knot that I actually use the most when I'm tying my horses. Remember, tie if you can, ideally, withers higher, higher. Don't tie too short. These horses get nervous, claustrophobic, can sit back. They can't drop their head. Don't tie them too long. That doesn't do them any favors. Then they get their feet and their legs and their head under it. Got to tie just about right. Sometimes about a foot and a half, something, maybe 2 feet at the most. So here is the better bowline again. Make the hole. This, my horse is on this end. Here's the tail of my rope. Go around the hole. Guys, and it wouldn't matter how many times you went around if you had a real long rope. So make the hole, go around the hole, then come right back here, pull it back through, tighten her down. And again, you can daisy chain or any of that kind of stuff you want. And that, my friend, is a better bowline. How do you learn these knots? Get you a little short piece of rope and practice them till they get imprinted on your brain, and it's going to make you a better hand, a top hand.